was originally supposed to be a little bit longer, the director's cut is, so I'm kind of making up that decision. Personally, I think of mine was a terrible thing to waste. I want to welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the second annual Las Vegas Academy Variety Show. This, of course, as you guys probably know by now, is a benefits production. The profits go directly towards scholarships for the students here at the Academy. Tonight's theme of the show is called Moving Towards Tomorrow. And tonight's acts come from a variety of majors, including musical theater, vocal music, theater, you know, instrumental music, dance, and encompass a variety of different styles. Tonight we'll see everything from mime, as we just saw a few minutes ago, and improvisation, stand-up comedy, and the brightest stars of tomorrow, presenting the top Broadway musical numbers of today, as well as popular music that you might hear on 98.5 KLUC, the number one hit music station. I should get my plug in now while I have the time. I'm Jay Casey. I host the morning show at 98.5 KLUC. But tonight, I'm your host here at the Las Vegas Academy Variety Show. I welcome you all to the program tonight. And we're going to kick things off right now with a number from Lindsay Hudgens and Kelly Fotheringham from the Broadway musical Miss Saigon. Here's I Still Believe.
The name I heard to speak.
who's changing her clothes right now as we speak. I'm speaking as slowly as possible to stall for time. One of the Academy's up-and-coming freshmen, Kelly Fotheringham, back again, as she's ready to perform I Don't Know How to Love Him from the musical Jesus Christ Superstar.
Thank you. I don't know just how, but it's not over till you want. Thank you.
the guys at Musical Theater Major Search Academy and how appropriate that song was, considering they all plan to take New York by storm coming up next fall. And now a more contemporary ballad from Bette Midler. Here's Night and Day, performed by vocal music major Jarrah Rance and interpreted in dance by musical theater major and civic ballet company member Angelina McCoy.
Bye.
school at Caesar's Palace. She's in charge of valet parking.
Let me I got it in time. It was embarrassing. Glad I didn't.
Former Sweet Jane by the Cowboy Chunkies. That was the Jane Hatcher, John Cornell, Dave Blake, and Ryan Hayner. For you now, our next entertainer is not going to be singing. Director of the Academy Improv, here's Chris Engine Drone delivering his unique comedy routine for tonight. Check out.
I'm going to. How many people have ever been to a doctor's office? Okay, I'm going to rephrase that. How many people actually like going to the doctor's office? That's what I thought. No, you're at a bad doctor's office when the people's name from yesterday's sign-in sheet were on today's obituaries. I'm not trusting any guy standing over me with a knife saying he's just practicing. And how about those fun-filled family vacations, huh? Can't wait till summer rolls around so you can go on another one of those again. You know, my dad had the best job on any vacations. His main objective is to get everyone there in as little time as possible with only a few casualties. He's always going for some world record or something. He wants to get there and tell everyone in the town,
yep, made it here under 5 hours.
And women are already going on these new fat diets these days. Here's an example. But what they don't realize is, every time they go on a diet, the men lose all the weight. Here's an example. Last week, me and my girlfriend went out to a restaurant. I order a burger and fries so greasy you don't even have to chew them. They just slide right down your throat. And because of her diet, she orders a salad with dressing on the side, of course. Then the food comes out, and I don't want to know my food. I look over and I see her staring. So I'm sitting there and I say, want a bite? And that, for women intuition kicks in. You know, I'm not really cheating on my diet if it's not actually my food that I'm eating. So she mutters those words made famous by women all over the world. Oh, maybe I'll have just a bite. Next thing you know, she starts out my burger and fries, and I'm left there to pick it herself. And people are working out a lot these days, you know, pumping iron and all that. But I can't stand these people who complain about not being able to find a close parking space at the athletic. I mean, will it really hurt you to walk 30 feet when as soon as you get in the door, you're going to run a triathlon anyway? You know, if they were real smart, they'd park real far away like me, walk all the way to the door. By the time they get up there, they're done exercising, they can take a few bucks and go. And cops are cracking down on crime a lot these days. Just last week, I got arrested for leaving the toilet and the handicapped called the restroom. I wonder what these bike cops are doing, huh? Like I'm supposed to be intimidated by some kind of bike. What happens if you catch some big-time criminal? All right, buddy, you're under arrest. Up on the headphones. Thank you for watching.
This is getting a little ridiculous that somebody like me, with my raw talent, my abilities, my charisma, my stage presence, and my good looks, has got me pushed around by somebody like that.
You didn't even make it to the show.
Oh, yeah.
These are
tonight, country and western. We're going to change up the theme of our music here right now. It's one of those songs you might hear on one of those other radio stations here in Las Vegas, you know. All right, it's a number from Patti Loveless, here to perform. I try to think about Elvis. It's vocal music major Amber Adams.
Yeah.
Rick Atkins and Evan Lipp performing Two Lost Souls.
Heaven.
recently re-recorded as number one, originally made famous by Nielsen in the late 70s. Now, Lindsay Hudgens, Teresa Ryan, and Alyssa Goldstein present Without You in a Brand New Arrangement. Thanks a lot once again for coming out.